Military operations are performed in a complex and dynamic world where weather and physical warfare have an impact on mission outcomes. For example, ground vehicle mobility will be affected due to the state of roads. A dirt road can become muddy due to rain, or a road can be destroyed by an IED explosion. These dynamic aspects of the operating environment need to be represented in a common and consistent way across simulation systems for defence training environments. Correlated dynamic synthetic environments have been on the M&S community's wish list for many, many years, but are yet to be made a reality. A major issue is that current simulation systems are each responsible for their own representation of the environment, where the dynamic elements are often prescripted. This limits the scope for achieving simulation interoperability, which requires correlated environments to ensure fair fight in distributed simulation exercises. NATO MSG-156 started in 2017 to investigate how a dynamic correlated environment can be achieved for future distributed simulation exercises. Its members have been working on a solution concept that enables consistent dynamic environments. The group developed a concept demonstration to test the approach and to determine which technology or standards still have to be evolved. In this concept demonstration, various simulation systems were connected in a distributed simulation exercise where a convoy protection scenario was simulated. During the simulated mission, the convoy moves from its base to a forward operating base. At a certain point along the route, the weather deteriorates and rain affects the terrain surface, halting its progress. Later on, the convoy is ambushed. An IED is detonated along the road, and the convoy receives incoming mortar fire, damaging the road surface and forming craters in the terrain. Air support engages the enemy mortar position, damaging nearby buildings. With the threat removed, the convoy finally makes it to its final destination. A key technology for the proposed solution concept is modelling and simulation as a service, or MSAS, as this technology allows the dynamic synthetic environment to be shared among participating federates using the service. Working from the same dynamic data source allows the federation to achieve a correlated environment. A terrain server provides the current state of the environment to all simulation systems. This includes elevation, imagery, vector and model data. Weather data is served from a central weather server to all participants, allowing them to receive the exact same information about current precipitation, visibility, and clouds. The trafficability of vehicles is affected by the state of the terrain. A specialized model implemented as a service computes the soil state as it changes under dynamic weather conditions. To ensure that vehicles simulated in different simulation systems are all affected by the dynamic soil and road state in a consistent way, a trafficability service provides simulation systems the maximum speed that the vehicles they simulate can achieve, given the current terrain conditions. The effect of detonations on the synthetic environment is handled by a specialized service that handles both craters in the terrain surface as well as damage to objects such as buildings, roads and bridges, modifying the data in the terrain server. After each change made by this service, federates are notified to update their local representations of the synthetic environment accordingly. With this concept demonstration, MSG-156 has shown that it is possible to achieve a dynamic environment that is correlated across different simulation systems when using an MSAS approach. Having shared servers to retrieve and update terrain and weather data is key to ensuring dynamic changes are correlated across federates. And by providing various services to perform changes and queries, consistency and fair fight conditions are maintained. The way ahead from this demonstration is to test the approach's scalability and performance for the large-scale exercises and to standardize the required interfaces and data models. A fully correlated dynamic synthetic environment will help to better prepare NATO soldiers for the challenges that they encounter during future missions. The MSG-156 group believes that the MSAS approach presented has the potential to make this a reality.